pictures are there, but also all the supporting documents, although they're not there yet, will be there in PDF form if you just want to do the form as well. So all that is available online at foundersresearch.ca, and you can kind of join in. And so we've been working at discovering our faith, and so we've been working, the first thing we talked about our spiritual gift, where things that God gave us, or that we need to pass into a relationship with Him, our spiritual gift. And the last thing we talked about our heart, what's the thing that the passion that God has put in you, and I don't know why. I just put my big toe in my mouth. on the floor of the studio, and I thought, I wonder why they still do that. And you know what? I think it's gone. It's all gone. Okay, so I guess I went from 200 to 799 ability. But all of us have some ability. Most of them are a lot of courses that people are using to study in different buildings. These are things that we can do, and we just know that we can do them. And we just can't take them for granted. But then there's other things we also have. We also have some talent, that there are certain things. But, you know, you just got, you know, there's one of those places you're saying it's my name, you know, you're the strongest person in the world. And I think over here, I talk about you all the time, but it's just to empathize people, but, you know, hey, you're not, hey, I want to give a back to somebody, but you just heard, I didn't know that was different. And we all have those things, there's different talents that we have. Some of it's a black guy, some of it's more on the artistic side of things. And all this, amazing, you know, you get to think of how it is made up from parts that can be designed and you can see it not just in the interview. Because we all have our talents, those things that we have. And in many regards, they shape our perception, our passion, and our purpose. Now, the different abilities we have, you know, I could decide today that, you know, I want to be an elephant. Just like I want to be in the plant. I will tell you one thing for sure. I am not going to be in the plant. I am not going to be here in the plant. So for me, that's not something. So there's a reason why I am not fixing your thought. Thank you, Stephen, for pointing that out to everyone. So there are those guys that know the children or the your deal, and you can do that. It's your profession. Why are some of you guys your teammates? Well, because that is what you can do, and you're good at it. You know, why are guys architects? Why are guys, firemen? Why are they policemen? Why are they teachers? Why are they nowadays? Because they have an aptitude towards it. They have a skill. So in many regards, those skills, they serve your profession. Sometimes they serve your purpose in your life. You know, professional hockey players, they play professional hockey players. Oh, boy, they were really good at it. And it's kind of the same for the action and the purpose of their life. And in many regards, it saves our passion. Even though for some of us, we might not be expensive players, but you know, we would have to play baseball or hockey or those types of things. Why do you do a hockey game? I think you have aspirations from the guy and more. But you can say it's fun, right? It's just your passion. You're excited about those things. Why? Because you're an actor. You're pretty good at it. And so it's starting to take your passion, your profession, and your purpose. Our abilities do that. They shape where we go in life and what we do. But sometimes there's a little bit of confusion that happens, but I know a fair amount of confusion, and so this is good for me to kind of walk through some of this stuff. Just because I think sometimes I interchange the word gift and talent a little bit too easily. Because, you know, when somebody, I know some people that I've met that their skill is at a different level. Some of them would know so called we have to play here how to play with guitar on Sunday night. Jay is an amazing guitar player. He is incredible playing guitar. And I would say, man, that guy's got it. And many of those are wrong. He's extremely talented. He's extremely talented. But I don't know if I would consider it to be a gift. And we're going to get to that a little bit. Because I think sometimes there is some confusion about gifts and talents. And even as we go through this discovery, even through the spiritual gift test, sometimes the things that we're finding may be more on talent, ability side than they are on spiritual gift. And so we're going to look at some of the differences between the two. First of all, there's a talent and a talent. You know, everybody's got talent. Everybody in their head, whether they believe in Jesus or not, they've all got talent. Here's a gift only for those that believe in Jesus. in the world is because of life. And so that's the reason you have a spiritual gift. It's not because you were born that way. It's because God developed that in you. God qualifies us. And sometimes, in God's wisdom, God takes the talent that you have and he adds a spiritual gift on top of it. And so, I would say, if you go to the Bible, the Apostle Paul, before he came to know Christ, was a strong leader. He was an incredibly gifted man, who was gifted with administration, he was passionate, he had all these different things, all the things that were just to a good leader. But God came into his life, and transformed and changed his life thoroughly. And I think, and I believe, that God being on top of his natural ability, God gave a special endowment to the Apostle Paul to be able to do stuff that normal people would not be able to do. Because God took something that he had and he said, I'm going to take your leadership, natural aptitude for your leadership, I'm going to pour it into you. And you're going to have a special endowment from God. And that's why Paul could go into places that nobody knew about Jesus, and he could go and he could preach about Jesus, and people would come and he would establish churches, and he would be able to set up leaders and all these different things. God took a little guy with strong leadership, aptitude, talent, ability, and God transformed him and put him into it. But we're only beginning that when he became a believer. You are born with it. You're born with it. You just kind of got it, and then you develop over time and end up with it. Here's the gift coming. You receive the Holy Spirit, and you are born with it. So, talents when you're born, here's the gift when you're born again, and you come into a relationship with Christ. Talents can be trained and developed. You know, if you always have something to do with special, you know, you're pretty good at not being very well, you know, you go back and you get better and you get better and you get better. You keep working on those types of things. Whereas, here's the gift I know of, matured and grown. You're talking to God and trying to convince him, you're saying, like, man, I have this God's place in your life. God gave you something to specific gifts, and now God is maturing those and growing those in his life. And so, there's a little bit of a difference in training versus maturity. Now, this is where it really starts to get interesting, isn't it? Talents can be used for non-spiritual and spiritual purposes. There are lots of guys who use the mechanical equation earlier. You know, that lots of guys are on the system. And that's, if I'm using it, why are they doing it? Well, number one, they need to enjoy it. Number two, it's taking them money. And it's not about them. That's good. That's why God gave us talents, so that we can use those talents to reinvent the world, to give up, and do all those other things. But I don't even have to give a conscious thought to God about whether or not I'm using it. If I'm not a Christian, I'm not saying, am I using my talents for the glory of God? But there's not really that much concern about it. And so you can't take your attitude or your talents or your ability, you can use them for you. That's it. But you can also use for spiritual purposes. Just on the other hand, your prayer will be watched and ministered to others and for God's glory. Interesting story in the book of Acts. Peter and John are going around ministering to people. Peter is a guy that has a summary sorcerer that you can know. He sees the incredible things that these guys are doing. So he says, whatever they got, I want. And so he actually goes up to Peter and John and goes, I got cash in my wallet. Can I buy whatever it is that you got? And so he wanted to buy spiritual gifts. And he got Peter, says one of my most favorite I'm going to take a little bit of a break. So, our first thing is involved between time, resources, and money with God.
So the interpretation can be brought to the temple. It's also the truth of Christ. It's using whatever you have on a larger scale responsibly. So if you have your Bible, if somebody want to read that for me, Matthew 25, 14 to 30, you do 14 to 16, okay? Number one is that we notice at the very beginning the talents were given by the emphasis of God, the prophets, the prophets, the prophets, the prophets. And the talents were given by the owner. There's a not the owner. They were stewards of it, which means that they didn't have any responsibility because they weren't there to steward. They were given these funds because the master had entrusted them to them. But they were not the owners of it. They were just the trust for the owner of it. Thank you.